Hi everyone and welcome back. And it's time to do a quick recap. Whatever we have done, we are exploring a lot of options of using TypeScript with React, like using TypeScript with a class-based component, with a functional component, with the different type of hooks, how to define the prop types, how to define the state, and how to define the props. All these things we have seen in the past 7-8 videos. Now we will do a quick recap and then we will build some applications which are using like the Redux, which are using some complex hooks like use reducer context APIs. We will introduce TypeScript there and we will build something which you can show on the screen. Okay, before that, let's have a quick recap, like how to introduce a TypeScript and all these like create React app and Next.js, all these framework you can say provides the TypeScript support. Like in create React app, this is a library. What it helps you to create a boilerplate. So you can specify the template as a TypeScript. So it will introduce all the type definitions of the React, React DOM, and whatever the library you are adding. Or if you're creating the Next.js application, then also you can do the same thing, create next app and just define the template. So what is getting changed when you are using the TypeScript in the React, okay? It's better that you should use the import definitions like this, import everything, and then wherever you are using use state, use effect, you can specify react dot use state, react dot use effect. Now, when we are getting started, like the basic functional component, how we are writing a simple function and then arrow functions and it is returning a JSX. How you can introduce a TypeScript? TypeScript is nothing but defining the types for the props for the state. So this is taking message as a props. So I have defined a separately a prop type, app prop, and I'm just specifying it here, right? There are many ways of doing it. You can define, you can just include a different type, or you can just define that message in this object is of type string. Okay, and what this method is going to return? A simple JSX element, okay? Sometimes you might have seen that react.fc is written there, but it's discouraged. Like we don't need to write a react.functional component, react.functional component. I mean, you can just put whatever this component is going to return. Okay, simple use state. Whenever you are type specifying the types, the type is getting inferred to a boolean. But if you want to explicitly specify what type this state is going to be, then you can specify that using generic style, like it either it is a null or either it will represent some user object. Okay, and this is the iUser, is an interface or a type. Okay, it can be an empty object, iUser as a iUser, empty object as iUser. And if we talk about the reducer, like use reducer, which is a hook, then it is again going to be the same. Here we have to define the types. So this is simple use reducer. We have to specify, okay, what is the action type? So we have created a type for the action type. This is the initial state and action is the section type, which means it will receive a type and the payload. Based on the type, we will return the new state. Then similarly, we have a use effect, use reference, use layout, and all these different hooks, right? Whenever we are actually referencing a DOM, and how we are always going to use HTML div element, right? Because we are adding a reference to a particular div element. This is a div element and we are using useRef, and this is applied onto this div element. Then whatever you wanted to do, like div reference.current.value, then you can access this DOM inside useEffect or anywhere you want. Okay, mutable reference. Here I'm just changing the reference. So here interval reference, and it is either of type number or a null. And inside interval reference, I'm just getting the current value, and I mean it is just a set interval inside a use effect. Okay, when we are building a custom hooks, there also we need to define the types. Like this custom hook is doing nothing but giving us the two different state, loading and the load state. Let's see about the class-based components, right? So we are also writing a class-based component, something like this, class app extends react.component. Here you can specify, you are specifying the two types, props and state. So props and state are two explicit different types which we have already created that we are passing here. So you can see my state is having the count, and then you can access it using this dot props dot message, this dot, this dot state dot count. Okay, I mean defining the types in this in the class-based component can be different. Either you explicitly created two different types, or you specify the types here. Okay, this is the props message, this is the count inside a state, instead of creating a new set of types. Okay, class-based properties and all. Now in the class-based component there are a lot of lifecycle methods like component did mount, get derived state from props. So you have to define the typings. Prop will be of props, state will be of state, the same props and state which you are receiving inside the component. Okay, default props. Sometimes you also want to initialize the props as a default props for the component. So you can do something like this. Type greet props, right? This component is receiving greet props like this. Okay. And this is age is optional. Okay, that means you may skip passing the age, but when you are not adding this question mark, that means the age is required as a props and you have to receive this age as a props. Okay, so in the class-based component what we can do is this is how we are actually doing a default initialization of a props. You can call it as a default props. If age is coming from the parent component, then receive it, otherwise assign 21 to the age. Okay, this is how it is working. I mean, earlier in the class-based component, the default props was acting differently. I mean, it was like, if you're not passing, then default props will be set. Here, default props, we are setting it here only. Here, we are passing 3. That means the age will be 3 and this is optional. So, if you're not passing, the age will be 21. Okay, here default props is also a type in the TypeScript. So you can say default props is 21. Okay, and you can also assign the component.default props as a default props. This is how we used to do earlier. The class-based component name dot default props equal to default props object. Okay, same thing here. It is doing type of greet.default props, either otherwise age is number. So you don't need to introduce the two different types. Consuming component within a default props. So there are a lot of examples and we are going to see all these things. Basic prop types. This is a big object which we are passing. These prop types can be a method, can be a variable, can be an object like this. These are like primitives, and then this is a string array. This is a type either, this is of string type, either waiting and success. This is of an object, this is of an array of this object. This is a function, this is the onClick DOM event, right? This is the onClick DOM event of a mouse event, like button click event, change event and all. These all can be your props for a component. And these are, we have already talked about this. Childrens can be a React element, React elements array, React children, React node, all these things. Okay, I mean this is just a difference like what all you can do, what all you can use, where you can use a type, where you can use interface. And so this is how our journey is going to be in the future. When we introduce types, it always feels like we are writing a lot of code, but the typings is giving you safety from the compile time error, or you are trying to access some property which is doesn't even exist, right? And you try to access it. So simply a DOM event, we have already discussed about this. Let me just copy this here and we'll talk about it. So what we are doing here is I have a type state and I have written the onClick onChange event here. So onChange event, the event object is of type react.form event, HTML input element, okay? Or react. It can be a change event also. And here on the onChange, we are updating the state from the event.currentTarget.value. Okay, and this is the state we have initialized text. Currently, we are not accessing anything from the props, so there is no types has been added. So state is having text and we are updating the text value using this dot set state. This is how we do the we write the DOM events in the class-based component, right? So here what we do is react.changeEventHandler. Change event handler can be of type different type. Change event, form event, on change event, click event, all these different kind set of events we have. Okay, like you can see, all the like type of events: change event, drag event, focus event, form event, pointer event, wheel event. Okay, context APIs. Another important aspect, we have seen the hooks, we have seen the class-based component, functional component. This we will take an example also, how we are creating a context, react.createContext, and then whatever you wanted to initialize with for the context. So this is the app context interface that is going to have a name, author, URL, or by default it is null. That means nothing. And then here we are initializing the context of type app provider interface. This is the default value, you can say. I'm providing name, author, URL. This is a new type. This is a new, you can see the variable of type app context interface, and I'm passing this in the provider. This is the value, right? This is how I'm passing this, and my child components will be receiving this. So I created a use context, and my child component, like the post info, is accessing it using app context.name, app context.author, app context.url. Context means something we are setting in the root parent context provider. So the child component can access it using appcontext.consumer, or you can also use a hook, react.useContext, and from that context you can access these values: name, author, URL. Okay, now what we will do is let's talk about all these examples with the real world scenarios. We still need to cover the React Redux with the TypeScript, React Router with the TypeScript, these context APIs, maybe some more hooks. So what I'm trying to do in the coming set of videos, 3-4 videos, I will still talk about these basic fundamentals with the TypeScript, and then we will write few full stack clone applications, very small. So you will understand how to introduce the TypeScript, how to define the typings in different scenarios. Okay, thanks everyone.